Okay, welcome everybody to Friday's Beauty Bands. I thought more of you would be here considering it's raining outside. Okay, it doesn't matter. Hopefully you guys will do the recording. So, hands on your hips, feet hip distance, circles with your hips. There's no jumping today. Hopefully you're happy to hear that. But we have three exercises from standing and four exercises from the mat, reverse directions. All right, keep your feet where they are. You're gonna push your hips back, okay, nice straight legs, and then gently drive the hips forward, mini back bend, but really you're stretching out through the hip flexors. Let's do that four more times. And press. Good. Three, two, feel that nice stretch through the back of the legs, and nice stretch through the front of the body. All right, let's come down into one inchworm down to the mat. So let's come to the end of your mat, inhale, arms up, and exhale, folding forward, walk it out, two plank, let's step forward. With that right leg. Okay, let's keep it active here. Keep your back leg lifted. Take the arm, same arm as the leg, reach it across and open. Good, three more. Two. And last one. Good. Plant your hands, step it back, other side. Sink the hips first for one breath. All right, now let's inhale, reach across, and exhale, twisting. Three more. Two. And last one. Good, plant your hand down, step it back, walk your hands back to your feet. Let's just forward fold for one or two breaths. Slowly rolling up to standing. Your head comes up last. Shoulder rolls at the top. Okay, let's grab your band and we'll do a few more warm-up exercises with your band. Okay, cool. So the band goes above your knee about 3, maybe 4 inches. All right, we'll start with squats first. All right, so squat nice and low and up. We're just gonna go for 8, 2, 3, 4, 5. Last 3, 2, and last one. Okay, we're gonna go kickbacks. So either standing against the wall or working on your balance, hands at your chest, turn your right toes out slightly, drive your leg back. All right, kicking back with the heels, nice straight leg. Good, 5 on this side, try not to move the upper body, nice and stable. 3, 2, last one, let's switch sides. Turn the left toes out slightly, drive back with your heel. Try not to lean forward. If you find yourself leaning forward too much, you might want to come in front of a wall. Hands up, looking forward. I just got really hot in here, like humid. 4 more. 3, 2, and last one. All right, we're only going to do 2 rounds of everything. Okay, so first exercise is going to be a squat and a kickback. So you just did it there, but we're going to combine the movement. All right, so feet squat position. We're going to go for 40 seconds rather than time it. Sorry, rather than counting reps. All right, so you're going to squat and kickback. Ready and go. Squat, same thing, kickback. Squat, other leg, kicking back. Good, keep going. Alternating legs. Drop it into a squat in between every time. All right, if you want to take this up a notch, you're doing a squat jump. All right, to kick back. I'm not. But if you want to, you can. All right, good, good, good. Keep going. We got 10 seconds left. Keep your feet wide in that squat position. 5 seconds. 2, and last one. Good. Take a moment. We're going to go curtsy lunge to like a side kick. So it looks like this. Feet hip distance. You're going to curtsy lunge and then bring your leg out to the side. Kick it out to the side. Okay? 8 on one leg, and then we switch 8 on the other. Coming up to standing feet hip distance. Hands can be up at your chest. Let's go. Lunge and kick it out. Good. Right into that lunge again and kick. So if you can, that foot never touches the ground. All right, this is 4. We're going up to 8. 5, 6. Last 2. I feel like a smurf. I just looked in at my reflection. I mean, I've been looking. With the white and the blue pants, feel like a smurf. Okay, take a second. A really fit smurf, right, guys? Yay! Okay, other leg. Let's go. Curtsy lunge and kick. Good. All right. As you kick it out to the side, try not to shake or lean too much the upper body. All right. This is 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, you guys feeling this? Are you feeling this in the glutes? Yes. Okay, we're going to go crab walk to 2 leg lifts on each side. Okay, this will get your heart rate up a little bit. If you wanted to get your heart rate up, 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 you crab shuffle. Okay, so I'll show you the 2. So knees bent, you can shuffle, 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 2 or 3 depending on your space, and 1 leg on each side lifts. Shuffle, 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 lift, and lift. Or you can go 1, 2, or 3, leg lift, leg lift. All right, we're gonna go for 40 seconds. Come to one side of your mat, knees bent, let's go. I'm gonna do the walk. Can you tell I feel very low impact today? All right, no judgments. I did show you the higher impact version, so you choose what works for you. Woo! The glutes are burning already. Good, keep your knees bent though. We're down to the mat soon. 10 seconds left. Keep your knees bent. Kicking it out. Almost there. 3, 2, 1, and rest. The side booty burning. Okay, we're going down to the mat. Grab a sip of water before you go down to the mat. We're coming into up and overs. So from your hands in this tabletop position or your forearms, if you have sore wrists, okay, try not to dip between the shoulder blades, push up between the shoulders, and then lifting up through the core, all right? So nice neutral spine. Let's extend your right leg straight out. You're lifting up and tapping it over, up and tap it over. All right, let's go for 10. 9. Lift that leg as high as possible. 8. Good. 7. Now you're working the back of the booty, not the side booty anymore. I'm sure you feel the difference. 5 more. 4. 3. 2. And last one. Tap and tap. And release. Okay, take 5 seconds to reset the spine here. And let's extend the opposite leg straight out. Core is lifted. Let's go. Lifting up and over. Gluteus maximus. All right? The biggest muscle in your glutes. 4, 5. Good. 6, 7, this is like the power muscle. 8, you want to make it strong. 9, And last one, tap, release. Let me see. All right, thank goodness. We are going down to the side for clamshells. Oh, it's almost like you know how I'm feeling if I give you clamshell for a workout. Okay, heels together, knees together. Bring your knees up. Keep your heels together. Drive your top knee up. All right, we're going for 10. 9. Nice and controlled. Press the knee as high and away as possible. All right, we are halfway through. 4. 3, 2, last one. Okay, before we do the other side, we're going to our back. All right, heels together, knees wide. Okay, your heels are close to your bum. And from here, kind of like a glute bridge, you're gonna tuck your tailbone under, keep your knees wide, drive your hips up. Keep the knees wide, ladies. Tap the glutes on the ground, drive it up, hips down and up. Good. Keep the knees wide. Exhale as you drive. This is great for pelvic floor as well. This is 10. Let's go 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one, roll it over to the other side for clamshells. All right, so you can come down to support your head, or if you have any issues with your neck, come all the way down. Okay, knees and feet are stacked. Let's go, lifting the top leg up and release. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and last one. Okay, relax. Sip of water, come back to standing. We got one more round. We do everything one more time. All right, we doing okay over there? Yeah, okay, cool. So we're gonna go back to the top with those squat and kickbacks. Remember, you can always do a squat jump instead. All right, we're gonna go for 40 seconds and 5 seconds, starting with your squat. Ready, and let's go. Squat to kickback, squat to kickback. With that kickback, you're always driving back with your heels. Okay, try to keep your leg nice and straight. Try not to arch the back as you're doing it. Nice quality squats every time. Keep going. Awesome. 10 seconds left. How many more can you give me? In 5 seconds, 3, 2, 1, and done. Good stuff. We got curtsy lunge to side kick. Just switching up the music. Okay, curtsy lunging. Let's start with the opposite leg this time. Ready, and let's go. Curtsy lunge to side kick. So remember, the upper body is not leaning to the side. Try to stay as upright as you can. And can you keep your toe pointing forward when you kick it up? All right, we got 2 more here. And last one, relax. 5 seconds. Get ready. And let's go, other leg. Curtsy lunge to kick. Believe it or not, you are strengthening through the obliques here as you lift the leg up, especially if you're able to stay upright. Good. Good work. We got crab walk or shuffle to leg lift. Leg lift, one on each side. Getting ready in 5 seconds. Knees bent. Let's go. Two or three walks or shuffles, depending on your space. All right, keep your knees bent. Stay low. Keep your chest up as well. No leaning forward. Try to keep your feet at least hip distance the whole time. So much harder. Glutes are on fire right now. Keep pushing through. We are almost there. Ah! 10 seconds, ladies. 10 seconds. Oh, brutal. Almost there. 3, 2, 1. Okay, but guess what? We're now down to the mat for the rest of the class. Okay. Grab a sip of water if you need it. Okay, we got up and overs. So set yourself up. Okay, pushing up through the shoulder blades, core is engaged. Let's extend your opposite leg out first this time. Ready, and lift, and tap, and over, tap for 2. Good, 3, try not to bend through the arms. Keep your weight in the center, equally balanced. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and last 1. Good work. Take 5 seconds only, 5 seconds here. All right, extend the other leg straight out. Reset the spine and the core. Let's go, lifting up and over for 1, 2, 3, 4. Remember, no arching in the back. 5. You wanna keep a neutral spine as much as possible. Let's focus on just the glutes here and the hammies. Last 3, 2, and last 1, and rest. Okay, awesome. Coming down to the side for clamshells. We're gonna add a little bit to our clamshells, okay? We're gonna go for 10 to start. Heels together, knees bent. Ready, lifting, top leg up. And slowly lower. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. 2 more. And last one. Take 5 seconds to rest here, and I'll tell you what's next. We're just gonna layer in a little more work. So you're gonna lift your top leg, point the knee to the ground, tap, and then drive the heel up. All right, tap, and drive the heel to the sky. 3, good. 4, 5, 6. Do you feel all this work? I'm sure you do. 8, 9, and 10. Good work. Rolling to your back before we go to the other side. We're gonna do the froggy lifts for 15. So, heels together, place them close to your glutes, knees wide. Okay, knees wide, tuck your tailbone under. Let's go, drive the hips up. And tap. Don't let the band pull your knees in. All right, keep them nice and wide. If anything, pressing out. Actively pressing out. 4, 5, 6. We're going up to 15, 7. You feel your pelvic floor here. 8. Squeeze your glutes at the top. Feel activate your pelvic floor. Good. Five more. Four. Three. Two. Hold it at the top. Hold, hold, hold. Pulse the knees out for 10, 9, 8. Hips stay high. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower down. Nice work. We got clamshells on the other side. Okay, so we're rolling over to the other side. Get set up here. Everybody here, let's go. Top knee up and lower. Two. Good, nice and slow. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Last one. Rest for 5 seconds. We're going to go knee tap, heel to the sky. Everybody with me? Let's go knee and kick. Knee and kick. Good. Keep going. Three. Four. Five. Try to keep the other leg on the ground. It's going to want to lift off. Six. Seven. Eight, nine, and last one. All right. Roll over to your back. We're going to finish with the glute bridge variation. Okay, so just take a moment, just chill for a second. Position your feet hip distance, close to your glutes, knees are hip distance as well. And let's peel the tailbone off the ground, lifting the hips all the way up. You're gonna hold it here as you take tiny steps out. All right, can you stay on your heels? Keep your hips up, stay on your heels, and then walk your heels back. All right, walk your heels out, maybe 3-4 steps, and then walk your heels back. Keeping the hips lifted the whole time. Walk, walk, walk. Are you keeping your knees wide? All right, keep going. In and out, 2 more times. Yes, last time, hips stay lifted, a little bit of coordination here. All right, hold it at the top, hold, hold, hold. Let's go, and pulsing knees wide for 10, tiny pulses, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hold at the top. Last thing we do, I promise, marching bridges. Bring one knee up, keep your legs bent, and then place it down, other leg. Hips stay lifted. All right, bring the knee towards the chest. Keep your hips up, other side. Keep alternating side to side. Let's go, 10, 9, keep your hips up, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one. I promised you it was over. Slowly, slowly lower your hips all the way down. Hug the knees into your chest. Rocking side to side. If you loved glute bridges, you love that. If you hate glute bridges, you hated that. Okay, taking your band off, let's stretch it out. Wrap your hands around your right shin. Extend that left leg straight out, squeezing the knee gently into the side of your body. Good, cooling down. Take one more deep breath in. And exhale, arms out to the side. Bring your knee across your body for a twist.
Try to keep both shoulders on the mat, looking over your right shoulder. Breathing into your belly. Feel a nice release through that lower back. Rocking back to center, hugging both knees into your chest. Rolling side to side gently. Good, wrapping your hands around your left shin. Extend your right leg out. Squeeze the knee into the side of your body. Take one more deep breath. And extend the arms out to the side. Bring your leg across your body for your twist. And looking over your left shoulder. All right, roll all the way over to the side and press yourself up to a seated position. We're gonna start with our legs straight out in front of us, stretching up the hammies. Inhale, reach your arms up by your ears, and big exhale, falling forward. Just let your hands rest where they might. Not forcing anything here. All right, gently rolling up. We gotta stretch out the glutes, right? So you're either coming into a seated thread the needle here, which most of us have done these already, or you're gonna drop your legs into this pretzel position if you can. So whichever works for you, for your hips, for your knees, stacking your foot over your knee on both sides. And then the foot that's on top, you're gonna sandwich that foot with your two hands. Turn your body over that foot and folding forward. All right, feel this really good deep stretch through the hips. Right into the lower back, actually, as well. All right, lifting up and let's switch sides. Okay, good, hand on either side of the other foot, turn your body over that leg and then folding forward. Slowly